I think that there's something about parrots that is special just in their gregarious nature. They're very interactive in a way that I think people connect with.
Their kind of bodily movements, you know, the way they kind of turn their head. They're so interesting to just watch.
You see a group hanging out, having fun, partying, sort of. As a human, you see a lot of yourself in these parrots.
In the very south of Texas, a team of wildlife sleuths has gathered to share information on one of the state's most mysterious wild birds. These are the parrot investigators.
People in Dallas and Houston have no idea there are parrots down here. And a lot of people don't even know that many of these individuals are wild and wary and came here on their own. They're native. A lot of people don't realize that parrots are wild too, and they do better in the wild. And we have some wild parrots in Texas, including the red-crowned parrot.
Little is known about wild red crowns, but nature tracker Cullen Hanks is on the case.
They line up on the telephone wires.
I always see them in the houses in those neighborhoods.
Yeah, one of the things that we do know is that they have adapted to live in cities in South Texas.
Based on tips from eyewitnesses, Cullen is convinced to set up an old-fashioned stakeout, teaming up with local biologist Tony Manahan.
This is right when they showed up last night.
Okay. Every time I've had them, it's been a little darker.
They're looking to get a few of the facts straight.
When we started looking at it, nobody knew how many parrots are there in South Texas. But we know the general area where they come, where they aggregate at the end of the day. They're out there.
All right. Over there.
Yeah, over here.
Once they spot the gang, the chase is on.
It's very hard to follow them. You know, we're on foot as humans trying to keep up.
Look at all of them.
They're aloft flying, and they can cover so much more ground than we can.
Wow, look at all those.
It's tricky to get there. Oh, here.
It seems kind of simple. You know, they're the parrots. You count them, one, two, three. But when you see them, it's just this raucous kind of movement of activity, and it's really difficult to actually count them. It's just impossible when they're flying around to get a precise number. Hopefully having multiple observers will help. We have one ornithologist, but we have so many more eyes on the ground when we engage many birders throughout the state.
One of those eyes on the ground is Dr. Carl Berg. He's a bit of a surveillance expert.
Most of my interest is concerned with acoustic communication. You know, what other pet can insult you in French and Spanish and German, given the right training?
He thinks he's found a clue. By analyzing the vocalizations they make, he's been able to ID their contact calls or code names.
Parrots arguably have the most sophisticated imitative vocal abilities of any non-humans, including all the primates, believe it or not.
He's hoping to go deeper by bugging the homes of parrot families, like he once did with these Venezuelan parrots. To plant the mics, he needs a man on the inside. He turns to research assistant Caleb Arellano.
I've been wanting to work with parrots for like the last 6 years. Finally being able to do so is like a dream come true.
It's here at the Southmost Preserve that Caleb gets his supplies.
So this is, they have like three different piles of the PVC pipe on the preserve around here. So what we're doing is we're gonna be using this irrigation PVC pipe in order to make the nest boxes. This is a prototype one, and it's a lot thicker, and if you pick it up, it's a lot heavier. So we have the nest liners, and then we're gonna be cutting out like a section of the wire so that the birds can come in and they can use the wires to climb down and climb up.
Red-crowned parrots like to nest in cavities, tree hollows. The red-crowned parrot's pretty particular. They don't like something that's too small or too big, kind of like Goldilocks, it has to be just right.
The palm trees, which once forested this area, are now in short supply. In places where their turf hasn't already been taken over by farmland, humans often remove dead trees, seeing them as a hazard. Once installed, these nest boxes might give the birds the space they need to raise their young in a place where we can watch over them. Because a lack of homes is not the only problem, This may also be a case of kidnapping.
You know, unlike a lot of other endangered species, they're not necessarily under pressure from the pet industry.
Targeted by poachers looking to make a quick buck, red-crowned parrots are valuable on the black market. Often taken right out of the nest, baby parrots are sold in shady deals like this one, caught on video in an undercover sting operation. They're targeted for their speech. A talking bird is too good to resist for some people looking for a novelty pet. And all too often, the chicks end up in the wrong hands.
They're losing a lot of individuals from people capturing them and selling them in flea markets and pet stores. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife is very interested in and has recently nominated it for a candidate for listing for possible threatened or endangered species status.
So how do we know this could be on the way to extinction? Well, scientists put that together by looking at population sizes and how they change over time.
And to do that, a search party is being gathered at the local Audubon Society.
I'm really grateful that some of y'all are participating in the survey here in the Harlingen area. I think it's going to really help to have multiple observers.
What I've been doing is just reaching out to different groups that might want to participate, some of which were already tracking parrots on their own, and trying to coordinate efforts so that we do this all at the same time.
Okay, so this is the parrot that we are looking for. This is the red-crowned parrot.
I was asked to help organize all the volunteers.
Yes.
We had four towns that were cooperating in this study, in McAllen, Weslaco, Harlingen, and Brownsville.
Okay.
We might have a significant chunk of the global population of red-crowned parrots right here in South Texas. We're coordinating this wide effort of citizen scientists to help us count these parrots.
Teams of birders are combing the valley to uncover some of the mysteries about this talkative bird.
You know, there's no rule that says they all have to come here. They could be going somewhere else.
We all go to specific areas where we expect the birds to roost to see if they actually show up where we expect them to. So by doing it all at the same time, we can validate that they are individual birds.
And with the greater understanding comes a respect for their wild nature.
People just think that they belong in a cage and that they're a pet. So this roost survey is going to hopefully answer some questions. And the big one is, how many do we have?
These parrot investigators are building a case to make sure the red-crowned parrot always has a home here in Texas.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Wildlife Restoration Program.